Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Most Merciful. All praise is due to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon His fine and messenger Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his household and his companions. My dearest viewers, wherever you are, Assalamu Alaikum wa Rahmatullahi wa Barakatuh. Peace be upon you all. And welcome back to our show, Every Word Counts. Today, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to be going through some verses from Surah Saba. So here's the recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وله الحمد في الآخرة وهو الحكيم الخبير يعلم ما يلج في الأرض وما يخرج منها وما ينزل من السماء وما يعرج فيها وهو الرحيم الغفور وقال الذين كفروا لا تأتين الساعة قل بلى وربي لتأتينكم عالم الغيب لا يعزب عنه مثقال ذرة في السماوات ولا في الأرض ولا أصغر من ذلك ولا أكبر إلا في كتاب مبين ليجزي الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أولئك لهم مغفرة ورزق كريم.
These are some verses from Surah Saba, and we're going to start inshallah ta'ala with our words. الحمد لله الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. All praise is due to Allah, the one that owns what is in heavens and earth. الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وله الحمد في الآخرة. Also the praise for him in the hereafter. وله الحمد في الآخرة وهو الحكيم الخبير. Indeed he is the wise, الحكيم الخبير, all knowing. So inshallah ta'ala, the first word inshallah we're going to be learning today is الآخرة. الآخرة. Let us write it. الآخرة. Okay. الآخرة. الآخرة means the end, also the last. In Arabic we say الآخرة if we are referring to a female, the last. You say المرأة الآخرة, the last woman. Okay, the man or the male, al-akhir. It's like al-yawm al-akhir, the last day. So also in Arabic, unlike English, we add gender to objects. It's like French. We add gender to objects. So al-akhirah referring to the life of al-akhirah. Because there is this one and the other one. So al-akhirah means the life, the last or the next life. Al-akhirah, the word of akhirah comes from akhir. Akhir, the last. You say ta'akhara Adam. Adam went back. Ta'akhara, he went back. Anything that goes back to a different stage level is called what? It's called التأخر, when it goes last. Okay, تأخرت فاطمة, فاطمة came last, تأخرت, and so forth. So الآخر, you hear quite often in Quran al-Kareem, the word of الآخرة, and الآخر, whether اليوم الآخر, the last day, or the last life, which is الآخرة, the hereafter. Our next word, inshallah ta'ala, is الخبير. الحكيم الخبير. الخبير from خبرة. In Arabic we say هذا رجل خبير. This man is خبير, means he's an expert. Okay, he's an expert. خبير. And one of Allah's names سبحانه وتعالى is الخبير. Okay. الخبير. الخبير, as I said, comes from الخبرة, the person or the one who is aware of details of something. Is الخبرة. Basically, is الخبرة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-knowing. He knows the details of things, objects and everything. So he is الخبير, all-knowing. So it is, in humans we say, this person is an expert. Means he knows something in and out. He is aware of it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is الخبير. Before we go to the next one, to the third word, inshallah, look at the way how Arabic can be concise as well. If you say, أخبرتني, أخبرتني, in English, she gave me information. She told me something. Because الخبر, it comes from الخبر. الخبر means the news, the information. That is الخبر. So when I say, أخبرتني means she gave me the news. She gave me the information. If you say استخبرتني means she asked me to give me, to give her information. Can you see a long sentence, but in Arabic you can say in one word. استخبرتني, she asked me to give her details, to give her some information. استخبرتها, I asked her to give me the information or some of the information. So again, one word, but you can derive from it many, many of other words, inshallah. So that's the second word. The third word is liyajziya. Liyajziya from al-jaza, and it's right. Just to be aware of some of these letters, inshallah. Okay, liyajziya. I hope you see it properly. Okay, liyajziya. Al-jaza, retribution, basically. But in Arabic, not just retribution, but also in the good way, the outcome, the prize. So liyajziya, this word comes from al-jaza. Al-jaza is whether it's punishment or a prize. Okay, so it means both. If you want to be more specific in Arabic, you say thawab. A thawab is only for good. It's opposite punishment, opposite al-iqab. If you want to say retribution, which is al-iqab, you say al-iqab. In Arabic. So you can be more specific if you want, and you can be general. So you have choice. It depends upon what you want to say and what if in the context as well, because the context plays a big role in the language. So here al-jaza means both, whether punishment or prize, basically what Allah Azza wa Jalla has prepared for the believers. So these are our three words, inshallah ta'ala, from this verse, and we will read the relevant verse, inshallah, so just to test ourselves and see if we can see where the words are, inshallah ta'ala. Okay, so the first verse, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to read is this.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِهَ نَفْسَهُ وَلَقَدِ اصْطَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. That's the first. The second will be
وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ.
And the third verse,
ليجزيهم الله أحسن ما عملوا ويزيدهم من فضله والله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب.
So these are three verses for today, inshallah ta'ala. I would like you to go and see if you can see where these words are
the words that we are targeting, inshallah, today to learn and memorize and use, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. So we're going to have a break, inshallah, a short break, and then we're going to come back, inshallah, to go through some of the tafsir of the main verse for today, inshallah, ta'ala, and see how we can get connected to Allah through it, bi-idhnillah ta'ala. So I'll see you, inshallah, ta'ala, after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Welcome back to our second part of this episode, inshallah ta'ala. Now we're going to go through some of the tafsir of the verse of today. Alhamdulillahil alladhi lahu ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard wa lahu alhamdu fil akhirah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, all praise is due to Allah, the creator of this, of the heavens and the earth, and all praise is due to Allah in the hereafter. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Mahmud, and He is al-Hamid, the one that we praise and deserves to be praised in this dunya and in al-akhirah. Can you see? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always Mahmud. Before He created us, after our creation, and after death, and after the resurrection, Allah is always al-Mahmud. Allah subhanahu is always al-Mahmud. And subhanallah, from Allah's rahmah, imagine all what we receive from the Quran, Al-Kareem, the glory book of Allah, is commands. Pray, fast, zakat, nothing else, no explanation. Allah has the right to do that. All commands. He created us and He's given us commands. But see, look at the mercy of Allah. He is giving us all the means to, and He's like explaining to us that this ibadah, this worship, these obligations are good for us. He's showing to us that He deserves the glory. And He is the creator of the universe. And He is the creator of all mankind. We didn't choose to live. It's a gift from Him. It is a gift from Him. He is the one who created us in the best of pictures, the best of forms, and so on. It's a gift. And then He is explaining to us all the time throughout the Quran that this is the reason why I asked you to worship me. It's because I am the one who created you. I am the one who gives you. I am the one who sustains you. I am the one who provides you. I am the one who protects you, and so on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is getting closer to us. So when we worship Him, we worship Him and we're happy to worship Him. And subhanAllah, look at the beauty how Allah phrases these sentences. He says, وَهُوَ الرَّحِيمُ الْغَفُورُ. And He is الرَّحِيم, the beneficent, the merciful, and الْغَفُورُ, and all forgiving. Why He said He is the beneficent, the most merciful, and straight away, and He is the one that forgives, all forgiving. Why? Because here, if you look at the verse, يَعْلَمُ مَا يَلِجُ فِي الْأَرْضِ, Allah is saying, before He said, وَهُوَ الرَّحِيمُ الْغَفُورُ, He said, يَعْلَمُ مَا يَلِجُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. He knows, He's talking about Himself, subhanahu, out of glory, means it's Him. يَعْلَمُ مَا يَلِجُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. He knows what is in the earth, what is in the ground. Okay. وَمَا يَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا, and whatever comes from the ground. What is in the ground means what? الخير, the provision, food. Just name it, fruit, vegetables, grass, everything. So He is aware of what is in the ground. يَعْلَمُ مَا يَلِجُ فِي الْأَرْضِ, what goes inside the earth. وَمَا يَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا, and whatever comes out of it, means after the operation of planting and sowing the seeds, and then the khayr, the provision, comes out. So He is aware of that when it comes out as well. وَمَا يَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا, وَمَا يَنْزِلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, whatever comes from the sky, from the heaven, the rain. Okay. وَمَا So Allah, first of all, He's talking about His favors upon us. So that's why he said Ar-Rahim, to tell us that all this is because of my mercy upon you. So link these together. He was explaining to us how he is doing all these things. He gives the ability to the seed to grow and brings the rain on it, so it grows and so on, and then it becomes food for us and food for our animals and so on. So all this is because of his mercy. That's why he said وَهُوَ الرَّحِيمُ. And then الْغَفُورُ, and all forgiven. Why all forgiven? Because he said afterwards يَعْلَمُ مَا يَلْجُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And then he said وَمَا يَنْزِلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَمَا يَعْرُجُ فِيهَا. And he is aware of what goes towards the heaven, towards the sky. What is that? Our deeds. Our deeds, our good and bad deeds. So he's saying to us that, look what I am bringing to you. Rain, bringing food for you, from the ground, for you and your animals. When the animals eat, they grow and you eat the animals, cows and sheep and so on. So all this is from Allah's mercy. That's why Rahim. And then look at you, what you're doing. You are sending horrible deeds to me. You are sending horrible deeds to me. But don't worry, I am all forgiven. Allahu Akbar. That's why he said, وَهُوَ الرَّحِيمُ الْغَفُورُ. The beneficent, the most merciful and all forgiving. Means, just ask for forgiveness. Be connected with me. So subhanAllah, that's why Allah subhanahu always asks us to do what tadabbur means, to reflect upon these words. Don't go beyond, it's not how much Quran you read. It's not. Some people, even Ramadan, subhanAllah, they just want to hurry up and finish the whole mushaf in al-qiyam. No. Ramadan is for reciting the Quran to reflect upon it. And obviously, yes, be preoccupied with the Quran in Ramadan more because you have more reward. But the main reason for reciting the Quran is to reflect upon. And reflection brings this. When you start thinking, why this word is here? Why Allah didn't say such and such? Why did he say this? When you reflect upon it, you see how beautiful the Quran is. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Now this verse, subhanallah ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is establishing facts. Is establishing facts, even logically. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first fact is that He is the creation, the creator. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator. Alhamdulillahi alladhi lahu ma fi samawati. Everything have been created by Him and owned by Him. Not just created and he gave ownership to somebody else. No. He is the creator and he is the owner. And he is the only owner forever. So he's establishing the first fact. And that is the first thing we talk to people about. If somebody were to come to you and say, do I really need to pray or fast? Why this? Why that? Why these obligations? This is like a burden on us. Why? So you don't talk to him about salat. You don't talk to him about zakat. Say to them, okay, let's establish the first thing. Let's debate about the first foundation, which is, do you believe that there is a creator? Because that's what Allah starts with first. I see a lot of people, mashallah, out of good intention, mashallah, when they debate with non-Muslims, they speak, debate for hours, hours and hours in about things, and then the outcome of the debate, nothing. Because they didn't do the debate in the correct way, in the way how the Quran establishes the debate. The adab, the ethics of debate. The first thing you need to start with is what? Is, do you believe in the existence of God or not? If you have doubt, or if you believe that there is no God, then that is the first thing we need to talk about. We can't talk about branches before we speak about the foundation. So the first thing is to establish the first foundation, which is Allah does exist. The Creator does exist. So when you believe that the Creator does exist, straight away you know that, subhanAllah, if the Creator does exist, then definitely He created you for a reason. Okay? And He gave you some of His attributes as well. Al-Hamid. Alhamdulillahi. Like this. Alhamdulillahi alladhi lahu ma fi as-samawati wa ma fi al-ard. So the second thing is that this creator has attributes. And through these attributes, Allah is making us aware of Him. That He is Al-Hamid. Means he is the one that deserves the praise. Why? Because He has all the good attributes. So He is the creator. And then He spoke about Al-Hakim, Al-Khabir, all-knowing, the wise, to tell us that this creator does things out of wisdom, out of knowledge. Nothing is there out of His awareness, is out of His awareness. Allah is aware of everything. So that's the second thing we debate about. Because we established the first one that He does exist. Second, no way He will make us exist for no reason. All this order in the universe just like that. Definitely there is a reason. So when you believe that He does exist, then the second thing, He has these attributes, the good attributes, He's not an oppressor, and so on. So He is good, He's doing good with us, He's giving us out of His mercy, out of His wisdom, out of His awareness. And then, as long as He created you, and He had the ability to create all this universe, why can't He be able to bring us back? And that is called al-ma'ad. Why not? If you believe that He created us, why can't He bring us back? In fact, out of wisdom, He will bring us back because we've been doing good and bad. Okay, we've been good to each other and bad to each other as well. So one day, for us to gather before Him, for judgment is needed. And that's what we call al-ma'ad. Allah will bring us back to that. And then if we believe that there is ma'ad, definitely there is hisab, there is judgment, because these people will be brought back to life somewhere else to be judged. And obviously, if we believe that there is judgment, definitely there is jaza, means punishment for those who are, you know, who deserve punishment, Allah knows, and to entertain those who went through too much in this dunya. Tests, calamities, they've been patient, they've been good, they've been sharing money with people, zakat, they've been supporting humanity to have good quality of life, and so on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you think how He put these things in order, you say, subhanallah, it cannot be from man, it is from the creator of man. This is the end, inshallah, we came to the end of this program, inshallah ta'ala. I just want to remind you again, make sure you go to the website, inshallah, download the flashcards, try to learn from them, use them, speak about them, make them part of your life, inshallah ta'ala. And I hope, inshallah, I see you next time, inshallah, in this program, Every Word Counts. Until then, this is me, Hassan Bulagras, Al-Jishtimi, and Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.